Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. And hi everyone, I'm Tihani. First of all, I would like to say thank you so much to Welfare Secretariat and Organizing Committee for giving me this opportunity to share some ideas on a program Wednesday with Welfare. The topic for today is very interesting, which is self-improvement. Before I start, I would like to point out that this is just from my point of view and experience. Different people have different opinions and it's okay. Self-improvement is a lifelong process. It is a way for people to assess their skills, ability, consider their aims in life and set goals. In addition to that, as a Muslim, Islam teaches us for us to better ourselves by following the Quran and the teachings of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Now, let us get into the discussion and hit the road. First and foremost, planning. We must build a foundation for our self-improvement plan. You can sit alone in a peaceful place and then make a list of everything you want to achieve in your life. You can list every goal, ambitions and accomplishment you want to achieve in the future, not only in this dunya, but also in the akhirah. You can write anything and everything you want in life, no matter how ridiculous it is or how impossible it is. That's okay because that's your life. Secondly, motivation. You can be motivated by an internal need to learn as much as possible, or you might be motivated to study by an external reward like a good grade or a great job. We all need a little motivation from time to time because life can sometimes bring happiness or sometimes bring sadness. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us, so He knows our nature very well. It is why when we can find in many verses in the Quran that deal with our natural inclinations and bring us peace when it is most needed. Once you have set your goal and worked out how to achieve it, it is time for you to take action and to leave your comfort zone. The actions that you can take are: avoid negative thoughts, meditate, celebrate victories, and others. Firstly, negative thought. You have to monitor your thoughts and always be positive. Sometimes there's something happen in your life and you think you cannot survive, but actually you can. You have to believe that you can and always think that you survived so far and you will survive again, inshallah. And second one, meditate. Spending a few minutes a day controlling your breathing, zikir, inshallah, that will be very helpful when you have to cope with stressful situations outside your comfort zone. Lastly, celebrate victories. It is good to reward yourself for small triumphs. These will bring you motivated to keep you moving forward, inshallah. That's all from me. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I apologize if there is any mistake during my sharing. Stay tuned for the next video from Welfare Secretariat MSS. Bye!